Good day, Minecraftians. Purple Mentat here, bringing you episode 67 of my Agrarian Skies Hardcore Quest Let's Play. This gamepack by Jadedcat is available on the Feed the Beast launcher. Little bit of between episode progress to share with you. I set up two more full-size turbines, both of which are spinning at 23,698 RF per tick, bringing my total RF generation at the moment up to somewhere around 140,000. Not exactly, but close. I have six of them. Well, I have five spinning at the 23,009 and one spinning at 24 and change. So, yeah, a whole lot of power is coming in. Just short, or maybe just above 140,000 per tick. Up here, I added more power, more resonant energy cells to provide a bit of a power bank. And I also connected my redstone energy conduits in so that the tesseracts would supply the laser drill prechargers directly. Now I am guaranteed to have this thing running at full power at all times, and I have a bunch of resonant energy cells that will be at full power in case something catastrophic happens and I lose power from my reactor. If I check out my reactor, I can see that I'm floating around 824-ish degrees C as an average, and producing 12,000 millibuckets per tick. I think I can support one more reactor, but I haven't actually done the math, so I'm not 100% certain. But I'm floating in a sweet zone where I'm using 0.21 millibuckets of fuel per tick to produce 140,000 RF per tick. Yeah, I think I'm in a good spot. And my energy buffers on my turbines are probably maxing out. Well, there's one of them that's maxed out at least. There might be more. I can pretty much gauge the amount of power that I'm using based on these energy buffers. With two of them full up, it means I have an extra 46-ish thousand RF per tick that I'm not currently using. So, plenty of power still available from that system. If I want to go set up another four lasers, I could, no problem. Now, speaking of lasers, that brings us to the goal of today. Because if I take a look at gold, I have hundreds of extra gold dust, thousands of extra pulverized gold, and I bet that I'm in a similar place for iron. Nope, iron's pretty good. If I look at tin, I'm okay. Well, there's a lot of there. Let's look at pulverized. That'll give me what I need to know. So I have my tin. I have a bunch of extra shiny coming in from those endearing bees. Holy crap, I have a ton of shiny. That's so much more than I expected. Wow. Okay. And if I look at dust, I have a bunch of gold dust, a bunch of Sirtis quartz dust. And so it's only gold that's overflowing. Well, I bet I have a ton of sulfur. Yeah, I'm at like 500,000 sulfur and glowstone over 10,000 now. Yeah, I'm in a pretty good spot. So I want to build something to smelt faster than this room right here can do, because it's been good, and it more than kept up with one laser drill and was plenty great throughput for the longest time. Well, that time has passed, and it's time to build better. So I'm going to add another layer to my factory tower, because that's kind of been my go-to for a while, has just been build more vertically. So I'll be back once I have that layer built. Huh, I need to get another resonant reverence of the condor under here. Anyway, I'll be back once I get that factory layer built, and I'll show you what my plans are to make a super smelter. Here's my completed room from the inside. Looks a little different from the outside. I'm not 100% certain about the paved stone bricks as a ceiling. It seemed like a good idea for an alternate texture, but once it was in place, I didn't like it nearly as much. I don't want to add in another elevator back above again so I can get out. I actually tore down the elevator going all the way up to the lasers because it wasn't really doing anything, and I didn't feel like building a tower structure to support the lasers. Maybe I'll do that, build a neat little mining tower in between these two platforms. That could be a fun little cosmetic project. All right, so what am I doing up here? Well, I'm going to build a super smelting area, and to do that, I am going to be running a lot of redstone energy conduit and setting up a whole bunch of redstone furnaces. And, you know what? I don't want the energy conduit right there, do I? I actually want it here. So let me get my wrench and put on my armor for just a moment to collect those items that dropped. I am not wearing my armor as a general rule because it is causing a lot of issues with the sieve system I have over there, which I can't see from this angle. I keep accidentally picking things up, and I don't like that. So let's see. I needed border stone, alternate. Well, that'll do. I can shave that down with the saw that I have in here. One panel, one saw, two covers. And put a cover there. Put a border stone back there. Good. Now, what's the plan? Well, I want a place that I can send items and they will be very rapidly smelted. And the way I'm going to do that, actually, is going to be to run a bunch of power. We're going to leave that last space open for the moment. I'm going to have furnaces attached to that power, like this. And then I'm actually going to run another branch of power right there. And I'm going to have another set of furnaces attached there. I'm going to fill this entire room this way, because I have 100 redstone furnaces currently cooking. I'm going to be supplying these furnaces using some item ducts set to round robin mode coming out of a chest that I'm going to feed with a handful of export buses, precision export buses, so I can decide exactly what gets put in there. So let me show you the basics of how this is going to get set up. It's going to take a while for all of the brick I need for these furnaces to cook. Once I have that, once I show you the basic configuration, I'll come back to show you the completed project. So the bottom furnaces are going to input from the top and output to the bottom. And top furnaces are not going to do that. Setting up this line is going to be significantly more difficult because I'm going to need to go basically space by space. So I'll start doing that now. But yes. Input top, output bottom, and the top furnaces are going to input bottom, output top. And then I grab myself my item duct. I set up an input duct there and a duct with a servo on output on the bottom. Which means, yes, I'm going to be using an awful lot of redstone, iron, and tin, and glowstone, and all that good stuff on this build. But in the end, I think it's going to be worth it because I'll be able to move and smelt things extremely fast. And I won't need to whitelist anything going in. I'll only need to make sure that I have powered extraction happening. So I'm going to be here for a while, and I'm going to get this room built with all of the furnaces, and I'll be back once I do. Had a brief purple derp tap moment there and forgot that I was working with thermal expansion machines. I don't actually need servos in these at all, I just need to make sure that they are set to output, and the redstone furnace will happily output into them all on its own with no further effort needed from me. So, there. There's your correction. All in one video. You guys can put down the comments, and I'm sure some of you probably corrected me on the spot, the instant that I made the mistake, without even waiting the 3 minutes it took to get to this point. Thank you all for commenting. Time for me to show you the mostly finished project. Up here, upstairs here, I have a wonderful octopus spaghetti full of ducts, conduits, cable, and furnaces. All of them are being inputted to from ducts that are fed by four chests, all with item duct mode round robin being extracted. This is going to be where I store my processing recipes that need to be run through a furnace, for example, coal into graphite. And this one has two outputs because I expect to have large batch orders come in all the time. And these three are going to be where I put my iron, my gold, my lead and tin and copper, and all of that sort of thing. All I need to do to kick this thing off, let's grab a bit of gold dust and a bit of pulverized gold to get things started. And we'll put you in here and tell you to move stacks. And we can see that it's already showing up and being fed into the furnaces. And the entire room is lighting up with the glow of burning metal. If I take a look at my gold ingot supply, well, for one, I can see that I am more than keeping up with my production of pulverized gold and gold dust at this point. and my gold ingots are moving upwards at a much more rapid pace. This room is glorious. I'm very happy with it. If I do happen to hit a point where I am overflowing my furnaces and I do not have enough input, well, I have three chests in the back here with impulse item ducts set to dense mode, inputting into them, with impulse item ducts set to round robin, pulling out of them. So I will have a nice, how much does one chest hold? That's a 9x12 inventory for a total of 108 stacks by 3 is 324 stacks of items. Yeah, I think that I should be pretty good. Everything will eventually get sucked out by... Well, they won't be sucked out. They will be exported out into the various item ducts, which lead into either this interface or that one that's hidden away underneath things back there. So, hope you enjoy this design. It's time for me to get all of my different pulverized metals being moved into this, as well as set up all of my crafting recipes that I might need to craft on demand in this area. Crafting recipes are the easy part. I have them all right, well, I have the few that I have down here, so I'm just going to grab those and move those upstairs. I'm also going to grab a bit of coal and a graphite to teach it how to make that, just in case I decide to make a bunch of turbines in the future and I run out of the 900 or so graphite bars that I have. It'll be able to craft that on demand from now on. Here we go. Encode that. Take it with me. I'm moving a little slow because I don't have my haste chest piece on because it also has my magnet sigil in it. And that's really not that great. Like, it doesn't work. Okay, so if I input these into here, let's see how fast it can craft me, say, toast. I want a stack of toast. Go. And I should see bread filling into here very quickly. And if I take a look at my toast, that should start coming into the system anytime now. Yeah, this is moving pretty quick. And that's with the gold all going at the same time. I am very happy with that system. It is probably the fastest option in this particular mod pack. I might be able to get more out of my gold. Actually, I have an idea to get more out of my gold. Hang on, I need to shut off my gold pulverizer to make this work. So I need like another 400,000 or so gold if I want to autocraft this. There is an option to make the singularities through infusion crafting. Thing is, if I show you the recipe on that, the dimensional singularity, I can either make it with a block of gold and two ender pearls, which doesn't really save me anything, or two ender pearls, a diamond, and an unstable propolis. And I'm also going to need 15 vacuous, 20 permutatio, 10 alienis in an infusion recipe. It only produces 3. I would need to do this recipe like 1,400 times to get the magnets made. I'll stick with the recipe that was added to this pack instead. The quartz is, you know, going to be an issue, but I'm working on it. I'm at 75,000 of 500,000, so it'll just take some time. All right. Let's get the rest of what we need. So, I think the easiest way to do that is actually going to be to temporarily disable the output of all of these. Or, you know what? It'll probably be to just flat out remove these guys. Whoops, what are you? You are iron. So if I take you up and then remove you and you and start that process going all the way down the line. This is gold. Whoops, I don't want to shift right click the precision export bus or it will remain pre-configured and will not stack. And then I'll have a mess on my hands. You do copper, so I'll grab you. And I can use the pickaxe on the furnaces. It's just, you know, not the best. All right, I want to stop my tin. And I'm going to get this cleaned out. Once I have it all, I will return. There we are. I have all of my automatic dust smelting taken out from this area. I left in the pulverizers. They're going to keep doing their jobs, except for the gold one. You have been decommissioned because I have other plans for my gold ore moving forward. And I left in the automatic smelters that produce my default stocks of items, I guess is the best way to put it. I probably could have set those up here, feeding into my crafting chest. Oh, see, I come anywhere near it and I get some of the extra sieves and magnet mode do not work well together. It is an issue. Wow, that stuff got stuck. Didn't think that was possible. There. Go be with your people. I wonder how I'm doing on titanium. Let's check that out. I have 194 blocks of titanium. Crikey. Limestone. Magnesium. I don't have a backstock of either of those yet. And I'm still not able to burn through all the rutile I have even. So, yeah. Leave that going for the time being. So, if I take a look in my system for ore, I don't believe I'll have a backlog of much except for the gold. Gold ore is piling up, but that's okay. I also have a bunch of ores that I literally can't use for much of anything. I believe I could use mariculture to make... That was weird. Oh, coal ore popped in while I wasn't looking. I could use the bauxite. Wow, this is not cooperating. Hang on. The bauxite to produce aluminum? I don't need to. I have a lot of aluminum. The clay might be useful. I might start doing it just to get it out of my inventory, though, and because setting up those crucibles furnaces was fun. Let's see. I really need this to stop bouncing around all over the place. That would be great. Yeah, nickelite, osmium, sulfur is okay, but mithril, adamantium, a bunch of these are from mods that are not even in the pack. And they are registered to nether ores and being produced because of recent configuration changes. I should really start avoiding those. If I look at dust, I should have magnesium dust. Okay. Yellorium dust. That stuff I really need to make sure goes to one of these. We'll put them in here. Not that I'm hurting for yellorium ingots. I think I'm good for a while. I believe the yellow focus is getting me yellorium ore. I see it pop in every now and then. What other dusts do I have? Aluminum? Yep, we can smelt that. Nether quartz, fluex, iron dust. That can get smelted. Okay. So, the iron dust can be smelted. Good. The aluminum dust goes right in a furnace as well. Excellent. Get you out of here. So that seems like it takes care of most of our dust at the moment. I'll have to come back and keep monitoring this over time. But let's check out our pulverized. We have lots of shiny metal. And the thing with shiny metal is mostly I'm going to be using it to make enderium. So, I mean, these shiny ingots on their own, they're useful for making platinum upgrades and shiny blocks, but that's basically it. I mean, maybe I could do something with the nuggets? Nope. Okay, so I'm going to have to set up that to just start producing endless amounts of enderium all the time. That could be cool. So let me grab my pulverized metals. Ferrous, lead, silver. Tin is a tricky one. You know what? I think I'm getting enough yellorium in that I no longer need to worry about creating yellorium out of tin. So I'm just going to put tin in this last one on its own for the moment. That's going to fill up my entire system for a while. Set you to stack mode. I'm actually going to set these guys to do 32 at a time, just to spread the love around a little bit better. I think that'll be better in terms of using more of these furnaces all at the same time. Let's put silver, lead, and ferrous right there for now. None of those are particularly common, so it shouldn't be a problem to have them all on one. Ferrous, tin. Yeah, I can make more. Copper, right? We'll put tin and copper on the same one, and we'll put the iron over here with the other iron. And that'll be good for now. Almost every furnace is running. All of my pulverized metal is in the system being processed, except the shiny, and I don't have any dusts that I don't want to have. Awesome. So, Operation Massive Redstone Furnace is go. Moving on. Let that thing crank for a while and make sure that we're all good. If I want to get all of the shiny all of the time, then what I'm going to need to do... you know what? That's right. This guy uses pulverized tin. The only thing going into here is pulverized tin and pulverized shiny. So I think maybe... Let me think about this and figure out how to fix it. Okay, so the solution to the shiny issue for the foreseeable future is going to be using it and all of my tin. To do that, I'm just going to pulverize a little bit, and I'm going to wait for more pulverized tin to come into the system, and I'm going to teach my system to use all of the pulverized tin and pulverized shiny it gets to make Enderium. And that's a very simple process of just sticking a precision export bus there, grabbing out some shiny and some tin. There's a lot of princesses. Ah, everything pristine is showing under tin. Cute. All right. So move stacks of pulverized tin at a time. And we're going to make sure that the top half is covered with tin. I don't think that'll even be enough, honestly. Like, this thing is going to... I'm going to need to wait for this thing to fill up with a whole bunch of tin before I start trying to process that shiny. Or it's going to burn through all of the shiny I have. And then stop. I might need to get a golem in here to tell it to keep just a little bit of each in there. Yeah, you know what? I like that idea a lot. Be right back. Alright folks, did a bit of crafting and some Thaumcraft stuff, made myself another golem, a golem animation core fill. How have I never scanned these? What is up with that? I say scan everything all of the time and then somehow I miss something important like the accessories and the freaking flesh golem itself. I'm fired. That's it. Okay. Seriously, I honestly thought that I had scanned these. It must have happened some other time. All right, so your fez accessory, your bow tie accessory, and your spectacles accessory. Almost completely useless for the golem that I'm going to be using, but I have decided that every golem I own must be properly equipped with these accoutrements, I believe. Yes, that's a good word for it. All right, golem animation core fill, and the flesh golem. I use flesh golems everywhere. Why is that not scanned yet? How have I never done... Like, I swear that I have pulled my scanner out and looked at that... Oh, you know what? The flesh golem item has different aspects than the living flesh golem itself. This tells me I should pick up my thaumium golem and scan that. Where is my golemancer's bell? Not on hand. Alright, we'll do that in a minute. Oh, hey, speaking of scan everything, I guarantee I haven't scanned that thaumium boss. Oh yeah, I did, because I scanned the first one I had. Never mind. Trying to be clever here, failing miserably. All right, so I'm going to toss this golem here onto the side of this inventory right here, the cyclic assembler. There we go. And I'm going to give him the animation core fill, the earth upgrade, and the order upgrade. So now I can tell him to keep two things filled. I could use colored inventories, and it is now on precise amount. I want you to keep precisely 64 shiny metal in there and 64 pulverized tin in there. But you don't know where to get it from yet because I don't have that Golemancer's bell on me. So, there we go. And now I can put my shiny and tin and such back. And go get my Golemancer's bell, which I believe I have hanging out over here in my Thaumcraft chest. Or it's entirely possible I am blind. Yep, we're going with I'm blind. Awesome. Did not put my eyes in today. Come here, you. Thaumium golem. Give you a nice scan. Take off a... Zombie? Why? Angry villager zombie. Not the experience orb, not the aspect orb, the golem. There. Yeah, that is a whole different thing. Okay. So you are a use core, which means you need to be attached to that inventory. And I need to set you to bone meal. And for some reason, you are significantly damaged. You need to stop being damaged. All right, moving on. Give this guy his specs and his bow tie and his fez because those are awesome. And now, Golemancer Bell, right-click you, attach you to that ME interface you're standing on. And it will happily keep about a stack of shiny and tin in there at all times. Awesome. So yeah, that's going to eat up my Resident Ender and burn through my tin and shiny supplies fairly quickly. But now I'd have that running all the time, and I can grab that Enderium blend. Whoa, you're trying to craft pulverized coal. Oh, for upstairs. Okay. A little bit of lag going on. I think I have too many crafting things going on all at once, and the server hasn't been restarted in a couple of days. Let me do a quick server restart and make sure that everything's running well. Be right back. Back after the restart, things are running slightly better. Gonna get that Enderium blend that's being made now. And, I want to... You know what? I think I want to just always output to an induction smelter. Like, all of the time. And not bother with this, like, on-demand crafting thing. So, unfortunately, I can't just put 64 Enderium blend in the export config because this guy won't see it. So what I need to do instead, clear you out entirely, is make myself another induction smelter, which, do I have that programmed in? That would be awesome, but I doubt it. I do not. Okay. But I have one outside. I'm pretty sure there's one in my extra machines chest. I am wrong. I have done bad, and I should feel bad. That was weird. Strange graphical something. Okay, so, induction smelter. If you all remember, very simple recipe, just some invar, machine frame, reception coil, and bucket, none of which I have. So go through the motions. Of course I don't have any machine frames or reception coils, I just used them all. So I'm going to make myself another stack of each just to hang on to and make sure that I have a good bit of, you know, I'm going to keep a stack of all of the coils handy just because I have the resources in the room for it these days. The conductance coils will take a little bit longer. That's okay. Here, you, smelter. Yay. And I'm going to need a precision export bus. And some of that pyrothium, which I have a ton of at the moment, but that won't last. Guarantee it. All right. You go in here. And now I'm going to keep myself a huge stock of pyrothium that should never go away if I'm at all lucky. I can't imagine using all of the pyrothium that I'm going to be creating from this. So pyrothium, enderium, move or craft, and smelter right there. Turn you off. Input to both from there. Put enderium there. Excellent. And tell you to output both out the back. Not that I think it's going to need both, but still. All right. Wait for that to fill up, and we should see it running. Back in a second. Here we go. It's going to fill up. Once it's got the pyrothium full, then it starts filling the enderium. Once the enderium, once it goes through one, it will take a second to refill the pyrothium before continuing on the enderium. And this will be burning practically forever with the rate that I'm creating enderium blend out of that cyclic assembler downstairs. Take a look at my enderium. Well, I have 39 ingots. 294 blend at the moment. I'm slowly burning through my supply of shiny. In fact, I have a bunch of shiny ingots that I'm probably just going to keep an ingot form in case I ever want to make more. I don't know, maybe I want 1800 platinum upgrade someday because I'm doing something completely insane. Where was I? Oh yeah, I wanted to see about my pulverized tin. Yeah, that stuff is not going quickly. Basically, anytime I get some... I have extra pulverized gold in the system. That cannot be allowed to continue. I think I took my pulverized gold out of this because I had some bright ideas on getting more out of my gold than I was from this system. But we're going to put it in here for now. And I should see a bunch of gold ore cropping up. I have a few stacks of nether, gold, and gold. Unfortunately, we're out of time for today. Oh, wait. No, we're not. One last thing. One very important thing. So I was wondering why my dirt was not stacking up offline as fast as it was when I was online. And I realized that I forgot something very important. I never chunk loaded my chestnut farm. If I take a look at the chestnut farm on my chunks loaded overlay, yeah, there are those four chunks right there are not loaded. That's a problem. So I'm going to go fix that real quick. And to do so, instead of the standard that I have been using, I'm low on tesseracts. I'm only going to use the one chunk loader, and I'm going to stick it in this corner over here, and I'm going to set it to large size. Whoa. Hey, you know what I need? I need my warp book right now to go home, and then I need my flight potion out of my bag. Or it's right there. There we go. Really need more reverence of the condor ritual setup. I'll set some more of those up off camera. All right, gonna fly on over here. And we got one chunk loader. We'll tuck it under here because, no, we won't. We'll tuck it. Stick it right here. Okay. Because that's the only way I can guarantee it's in every chunk that I want it to be in. Come on. Come here. You are chunk loaders set. Block items. Receive fluid. Receive energy. You pop up real quick. Lots of energy coming in. Mob essence ran out. What the heck? Oh, you're sending. Bad. Stop that. There we go. I feel like I'm finally hitting the limits on what this one frequency can support for mob essence. I might need to add a second fluid export bus onto the same frequency. That might help me out. So right now, just that one chunk's loaded, but if I increase this to two, I'm drawing a ton of energy, but I'm using the same amount of mob essence, which was the plan. And now the whole farm, plus a little bit of extra, including that little platform, are all loaded. So, fantastic. Now this should keep running while I'm offline, and now I should see the kind of dirt production that I was expecting when I set this thing up in the first place, and have not been getting, and been very confused about. Okay, so tomorrow's episode is going to be all about the gold production. I am going to crank that up to the maximum. I have two systems in mind to build for it. One of which is going to be based on using the ore, and another one, maybe two others, are going to be based on generating gold through other means. And it's going to be a good time. I expect to have a lot of fun putting together as much gold production as I can manage without just spamming more lasers, because I feel like 8 is a good number of lasers. Oh yeah, speaking of which, I did fix... Oh, no, I showed you that. I showed you at the beginning of the episode that I fixed all of the energy. Sorry about that. This recording session has been fractured and all over the place, and I'm forgetting the things that I did at the start of the session now that we're towards the end of it. So yeah, that's going to wrap us up for today. Thank you very much for joining me, and I hope you've enjoyed this episode. If you have, leave me a thumbs up and a comment. If you have not, leave me a thumbs down. Tell me what I can do better. I will see you next time.